I think Northern Ireland's been a beacon of success. You know, the factors I don't understand. You know, you've got 1.88 million people compared to the total UK of 66.6 million people. So you're small and you're isolated in the sense you have to take a boat or a plane to get to Ireland. You do have the land border, and you know, it's which is obviously people freely go across historically. And that's been maintained. There's been no sort of border controls instituted for health reasons. And I think you've done incredibly well. The total number of cases are lower than the UK percentage wise. And the mortality rate, the number of people dying per infected person, is significantly lower in Northern Ireland. Your health service was never overwhelmed. It got busy with COVID and it has the same problems for cancer as we do over here. But somehow it seems to have been controlled. And I think your politicians, whatever party they come from, have worked far closer together than we've seen over here, where you've got a bunch of conservative ministers sort of playing some sort of relay game, telling us what they're going to do. They all look really as though they're rabbits staring into headlights of a car when you hear them talk. Part of the problem is that most politicians are not scientifically trained. You wouldn't expect them to be. That's not what you're paying them to do. But I think your guys and ladies, including your first minister, has really understood the problem in a way that we haven't seen the Westminster government understand it. And I think it's a tribute to them that we're going to come to the end of this with Northern Ireland being top of the four devolved, of the four countries of the UK. I think it's time to be bold. There have been bold so far. It's time to keep moving. Don't give up. You know, by all means, make sure you have plans in place for a second wave, but let's assume it isn't going to happen. And we can look at a way of getting us out of here so we can get back to normal. People wake up in the morning, and I know they're fed up with what's going on. They can't do their normal things, whether it's their job, whether it's their family life, whatever it is. We've got to get everybody back. Having the shops open is great, but we just have to keep going. And I think the mistake in Westminster was to do it only every 3 weeks. You're doing it more frequently. You're making little changes as you go. It gives people something to look forward to, something to live for. My desire is to have a pint of beer in a pub garden. That's all I want. And I know I'm going to get one in 2 weeks' time. Not open my own can of beer and sit in the garden and drink it, but actually go and buy one from someone or have it delivered to my table, even if I have to order it online. I don't care. I want to be able to do that. And I think that's my vision for normality. And I think your politicians really would like to get to that point. We've got to get moving to get people back to normal.